Watch WWE Presents. So Jeff Hardy is the definition of popularity through risk. He made a name for himself jumping off of really tall things, crashing through tables, and genuinely just writing a death wish. Hardy has remained one of the most popular wrestlers from WWE's past, and while many still clamor for his return today, he's already had plenty of fantastic moments. Prepare for the spot fest. I'm D Wicket from Watch WWE, and these are the 10 best moments. Jeff Hardy. Number 10, Swanton Bomb off a truck. And so the spot fest begins. So Umaga and Hardy were fighting outside by the trucks because fuck wrestling rings, and well, now that is a leap of faith. Number 9, earning Undertaker's respect. Aside from jumping off of the things with a note in his pants saying that he wanted to go down like this, Hardy's also loved because of his never give up attitude and how Hardy would always rise above hate and he was all about hustle, loyalty, and respect. Wait a sec, something's wrong here. Anyways, right around the time the Hardys were done teaming together in 2002, Hardy jumped right into a ladder match versus undisputed WWE Champion The Undertaker one night on Raw. It was a pretty damn good match where Hardy just came up short, however, he earned the respect of the dead man, American Badass, after trying to rise to his feet after getting the hell kicked out of him and attempting to challenge The Undertaker to continue. Ballsy Daredevil. Wait, that's a stupid thing to say. Ballsy Daredevil. Number 8, beating Triple H for the IC title. While still teaming with his brother in 2001, Hardy was also receiving a pretty nice singles push, having won the light heavyweight championship, what a good belt that was, the hardcore championship a few times, and most important, the Intercontinental Championship. However, what's even bigger is who he got the pin over. That's right, the King of Kings stayed down for a 3 count for Jeff Hardy. There might have been a little bit of interference from his brother, but still, you know, for all those burial jokes that Triple H gets, he was fine with putting over talent every now and then, and Jeff Hardy was one of them. Number 7, Whisper in the Wind off Hell in a Cell. Welcome back, Umaga. For the second time, you're being jumped on, this time taking place on January 7th, 2008 inside Hell in a Cell. Let's see it. Beautiful. Number 6, TLC 1. You can't beat the first. F*** off. While it's not the best, it is pretty damn good. The original TLC match came at SummerSlam 2000 where Matt and Jeff Lunatic Hardy took on Bubba powerbombing women through tables and Devon Testified Dudley, as well as the 5 second posing Edge and Christian. A classic match, we saw plenty of great work from everyone, especially Hardy who notably went for a Swanton Bomb off a ladder on the outside to Bubba and missed. Ouch. Number 5, TLC 2. There we go, the best of the TLC matches. Again, pairing the Lunatics versus Tables and Testify versus 5 second poses, all is good. If TLC 1 was a classic, TLC 2 was a pioneer when it came to TLC matches. Well, TLC 1 was a pioneer in the matches too. Fuck off, it's my list. I say whatever stupid shit I want. Naked Midian, yeah, deal with it. Anyways, Hardy had a great showing at WrestleMania 17, the best WWE pay-per-view of all time, and certainly had a very juicy spot you'll hear me go on about later, so you stay tuned. Woo, yeah, yeah, yeah. Number 4, Swanton Bomb off the set. Remember that whisper in the wind from earlier? Well, it only took Hardy a whole week to one-up himself, or, you know, like, 6.5 up himself on the spot counter. As this time, Hardy climbed up the set. I don't know what it is, the steel thing that looks really stable, sort of like a ladder, but not. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about, that thing. Well, Hardy decided to climb up 30 goddamn feet and Swanton bomb himself right the fuck off, right the fuck onto Orton, and holy hell was it fun. Number 3, that jump. You know the jump, the one that cost Jeff Hardy the Money in the Bank ladder match at WrestleMania 23 because his dickhead brother told him to jump. Hashtag Brother Nero. Wait, that's from TNA and you guys will haunt me if I dare mention them, so sorry. Play the footage. Oh, it just hurts to watch. Damn fun spot though, about 7 out of 10 on the juicy scale. Number 2, that spear. Oh, fuck, this is gonna be fun. Let's watch this together, okay? Oh, damn. Look at him. He's broken smack dab in half. Oh my god, I think I just lost my virginity to that spot. Jesus Christ. One more time. F***ing hell. And number 1, winning the WWE Championship. Maybe the spots were good, but, you know, still. the belt. Yeah, the belt. He also had two World Heavyweight Championship reigns. However, this always felt like the big moment. Finally, after all the years, Hardy hit it big. He finally did it. Jeff Hardy was on top of the world. He was the WWE champion, top guy in the company. And you know, because I'm an asshole, let me remind you that after this awesome moment, which I'll give it credit, it was awesome, yeah, great moment. But then, Hardy had a terrible run with the title, having a storyline that involved scripted accidents involving a hit and run and a pyro malfunction. Then just a month later, at Royal Rumble, he lost to Edge after Matt Hardy interfered and revealed that he was the cause of Jeff's accidents. At least he won the big one though, am I right? And hey, at least it set up that pretty cool WrestleMania Hardy vs. Hardy feud. I wonder where that was on the list. And those are the 10 best moments. Jeff Hardy, what are your thoughts? Tell us in the comments below. And if you literally jumped off everything, like the video and subscribe for more falling wrestling content, f*** you. Thanks for watching.